Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am coming at you with a video about your response to my email that I sent out and my post that I posted about what is your biggest struggle. First of all, I want to say thank you to everyone who responded to that, because what it did for me is to help me plan content going forward and, you know, really defining what I'm actually doing here. And I feel like I was on the right track, because I'm going to give you the top three things that came up the most. And I got hundreds of responses, and I tried to respond to every last one of you. If I didn't respond, I'm sorry, it's because I missed it, but I took time out of my schedule. Like, I blocked time to actually look at your responses and at least hit the like button or reply thank you. So thank you very much for taking the time to do that. So with this information, I am putting together information for this next year, and also enhancing my 90-day fibroid program with this information as well. So thank you, thank you, thank you. So what I'm gonna do here today is discuss the top three struggles that came through to me, and I'm gonna give you some tips on how to combat these. But first, I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson. I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related conditions using food as medicine, conditions like fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, infertility, those types of things. That's what I help people with. So hit that subscribe button, click the notification bell so you never miss an episode. Before I get into the topics, I wanna tell you that my 90-day fibroid program starts in January. January 18th is when it starts. But in order to join the program, you have to talk to me first. So you have to apply. So there is a button down in the description box where you click it and you'll have the opportunity to apply. Then you and I will have a conversation and see if the program is the right fit for you. So if you're interested, do that as quickly as possible. I only have a small number of slots left. So if you are interested, go ahead down in the description box and click that up, that button, so you can apply so that we can talk and get you started. So the first and number one struggle that you guys said you had, and it was probably 90% of what came through, literally 90% of what came through. And it's about the food and being able to stay consistent along with food addiction mixed in there. So I understand that. That was my problem, because I would start and then stop. And then I'd start for a long time, and then I'd stop for a long time. And it was just like this uphill battle, because I didn't know how to integrate the plan with in my life. But ultimately, really what was going on is I was addicted to food. And I didn't want to let go of the foods that I was so used to eating. The foods that I, you know, ate my whole life, and that I just didn't want to let it go. I felt like I could eat healthy most of the time. And then, you know, sometimes I could eat, you know, fried chicken here and there. But that's not the way it is. And here's the tip I'm going to give you. If you want to be consistent on this program, what you have to do, beyond a shadow of a doubt, like, you cannot dabble. You have to jump all the way in. You have to jump all the way in. If you don't jump all the way in, there is no way that you are going to make it on this program. So if you are that person where you keep on going back and forth on the program, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, you have to make a commitment within yourself that you are going to stick to it, stay with it, and not play games with it. So that's my biggest tip with it. There are so many recipes, so much information on my channel to help you be consistent. there's no excuse that why you can't be consistent. So I just want to say that. Now, number two is knowing how to heal. Like, I got so many people who message and say, well, I really don't know. I don't know what to do. Like, there's so much information on the internet. Like, some people say this and some people say that. Like, I really don't know what to do. I don't even know what to eat because some people say eat this and some people say don't eat that. So I don't know what to do. I understand that too. Here's how you overcome that. You pick something, whatever it is, whatever, you know, resonates with you most. You pick it and then you do it. You just do it. And you do it for like 6 months straight and then see how you're feeling. Maybe at the end of that 6 months, you might need to tweak some things. Maybe at the end of that 6 months, everything is going great. Keep on going. Just don't go this program, that program, and confusing yourself and driving yourself insane, because you will go insane with that. You'll get frustrated and you'll just quit altogether and you'll either go get on medication or go get the surgery like the doctor has been telling you to do for forever because of the confusion that comes along with going from back and forth to this plan, to that plan, to that plan. So that is the biggest tip I can give you about that, about how to heal. If you have in your mind about like what you want to do, do it and just do it with all your heart. And number three is stress and emotions. Stress and emotions. That came up number three. And if you're somebody, you have a high stress job, you have a high stress relationship, like things are going haywire in your finances, like your finances are a mess. Just your life is just a mess in general. You're full of fear. You're anxious. You're, you know, depressed, you're angry, you're bitter, you got all these emotions going on in your life. Well, first of all, all of that is going to cause fibroids to grow or exasperate your reproductive issues. It's gonna make things worse. And the reason I know that is because I've been there. I've been highly stressed. I've been an emotional wreck. I've been full of fear, anxiety, bitterness, anger, all of that stuff. And it causes your body to wreak havoc. It wreaks havoc on your body is what I meant to say. So the suggestion that I have, there's two things that I have suggestions for. One, sit down and reevaluate your life and change the things that you know that you need to change in order for your life to be a little more smooth. Maybe you need a new job because it's too stressful. Maybe you need to start budgeting instead of flying by the seat of your pants with your finances. Maybe there's some relationships that you need to cut off. So sit down and do that work first. Then you need to work on your emotional health with God. Like, you need to let him get at your heart issues. And you might be saying, Chelsea, I have no idea how to do that. Well, that is one thing that I do teach in my programs, is how to get at those heart issues. But I want to invite you, if you haven't already done it, I want to invite you to the 40 days of fasting and praying that I am doing in my Facebook group starting on December 28th. And I'm going to be praying for shrinking fibroids and healing reproductive issues, but I'm going to be coming at it from an emotional perspective. So I'm going to be asking God to come in and heal those emotional issues that are in your heart that are contributing to the reproductive issues. So that would be my number one thing. So even if you don't join me on fasting and praying, you know, identify what it is that you have going on as far as the emotions in your heart that are going like this. So for me, the big ones were fear, anxiety, and anger and bitterness. Those were the four. I was plagued with that stuff. So you got to start praying with why you're praying for why you do that. Like, why is that your problem? Like, why? What is going on? And then let God come in and do a work in you. And you might not have a relationship with God right now. And if you don't, start to get one. And all it is you don't have to have any special prayers or anything like that. All you have to do is just start talking to God just like you talk to your best friend. You know how you're on the phone texting your best friend? Well, talk to God just like that. He wants to hear from you and he wants to heal you. Jesus went to the cross so that you could be whole. So that's all I have to say about that. And the majority of what's wrong with us is the emotional piece. When you start healing the emotional piece, the other stuff kind of falls into place. Now you need all three of these. You need to get your eating under control. You need a process of healing, like what you should do to help your body. But you also need this piece. This is the big piece that wraps it all up in a bow. So those are my three tips that I want to give you for the three most popular things that came to me answers that came to me for the question I asked about what is your biggest struggle. So let me see. I think that is all I want to say about this. I hope that this video was useful for you. Again, if you are interested in my 90-day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program, click the link down in the description box below this video so you can apply, because I want to talk to you so that you can join. Because I want to work with women who are really wanting to, go after this thing, because I really want to help you. If you have spoken to me before and we've already had a conversation, all you have to do is email me and say you're interested, and then we'll go from there. All right. Thank you so much for joining me today. I hope that you have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. I hope you join me in my prayer and fasting on the 28th of December. There's a link down in the description box below to join the Facebook group, where I will be praying Monday through Friday at 12 noon and on Saturday and Sunday at 5 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. But until next time, y'all, take care. Love you. Bye-bye.